fellow freedom fighters, comrades and friends, long live African freedom fighters. Long live African independence. Yeah. Long live your struggle. Yeah. And long live African unity. Yeah. Support. Here is a phenomenon against which all African freedom fighters must be on their guard and resist to the utmost. Even though I appreciate the difficulties facing us, I must admit, I find it strange to watch some of us returning willingly to the colonialist fold. This time, they don't even have the excuse of being forced to subject themselves to foreign domination. It makes one wonder, why so much effort and sacrifice and so many lives were given up to the achievement of independence in the first place, if it can only be so quickly and easily surrendered. We must begin to build immediately our own continental common market, for it is easy for anyone who studies the common market organization closely to realize that the common market is aimed at harnessing the African countries to satisfy the profit lust of the imperialist bloc and to prevent us from following an independent neutralist policy. It is easy to see that the imperialists and the colonialists are determined to retain the African countries in the position of suppliers of cheap raw materials. If we do not resist this threat, and if we throw in our lot with the common market, we shall doom the economy of Africa to a state of perpetual subjection to the economy of Western Europe. This will, of course, hinder the industrialization of our young African states. It is impossible to think of economic development and national independence without possessing an unfettered capacity for maintaining a strong industrial power. The activities of the common market are therefore fraught with dangerous political and economic consequences for the independent African states. The organization constitutes an attempt to replace the old system of colonial exploitation by a new system of collective colonialism, which will be stronger and more dangerous than the old evils we are striving to liquidate from our continent. This is another reason why we should come together in a unified African economic plan, which, operating on a continental scale, can make a solid attack on the imperialist domination in Africa. We should, without delay, aim at the creation of a joint African military command. There is little wisdom in our present separate effort to build up and maintain defense forces, which, in any case, would be ineffective in a major world conflict. If we examine this problem realistically, we would ask, which single African state could protect itself against an imperialist aggressor? And how much more difficult this would be when some states are allowing the imperialists to maintain bases on their territories. Only our unity can provide us with anything like adequate protection. Those problems can best be met within a unified Africa, and it should be possible in the higher reaches of our endeavor to devise a constitutional structure which will secure the objectives I have outlined and yet preserve the sovereignty of each of the countries joining the Union. countries within the Union will naturally maintain their own constitutions, continue to use their own national emblems and national anthems and other symbols and paraphernalia of sovereignty.